What is up, guys? We got a first place deck profile here. You may have seen him before. His name is Jack Fast, who won with Perona. I mean, he got top four with Perona back in the day. Now he's taking a different list. What was the list that you played today?
I'm playing Red Purple Law. This deck is insane. The last three games that I won with an order. I had three Dawn on the field, then I had one Dawn on the field, and then I had zero Dawn on the field on the last one because
Dawns are bad.
Dawns are bad. I don't know why. I spent all my money on my Dawn, and it's still awful.
It just goes back in the Dawn deck.
This is back in the in the Dawn deck. I don't need those. Adios, bro.
This is the Manga Chopper that he won at the last ever Top Choice Gaming. Unfortunately, the store is going to close down. But maybe in the future, it'll reopen under new management. So,
yeah. I assume Top Choice will be back with a vengeance eventually.
Yeah.
The store is beloved by all. Yeah. So I won my first event I ever played here a little over a year and a half ago, and I won the last event I'll play here, I guess.
First and last.
And it's bittersweet. I'm going to really miss this store. This was what I did on Sundays and on Saturdays. This was my event. Call me boring, but sad and boring, but hey, I'll find something else, I promise.
Okay, cool.
And yeah, I'll show you guys the deck.
Let's go into the Law first place deck list.
All right, so most people, a lot of people run 7 or 8. I choose to run 8 of the reducers, the -3 Gordons. Everybody thought that Raise Max was going to make Gordon be cheaper. Nope, did the opposite. Turns out you just play all 8. This card's insane. You 2-for-1 yourself when you play it to when you try to get rid of anything bigger than a 6K, but everything bigger than a 6K costs your opponent their whole turn. So 2 Dawn to time walk your opponent, very strong.
Sounds good, yeah.
And then a lot of lists are only playing 3. I'm playing 4 of the Otamas. I think it's the best 2K counter in the game still. It's the second best 2K counter in the game. The best being Capone Beige, but Otama's insane. Being able to just pay 1 for the -2 helps a lot, especially on your 4 Dawn turn if you ever need to get rid of a Kuzan, or on your 5 or 6 Dawn turn if you need to get rid of a Kuzan, or something that is a 4 mana 5k that has value associated with it. Also against enemy Laws, it's very good against getting rid of their early threats, such as if they play Chopper, or against their Laws or other 4 drops they run. So this is the last reducer in the deck. I only play 2. Mainly because I'm greedy on the slots for other cards. I prefer running more Dawn Enhancement because this deck runs so many -3 costs that this is usually a little overkill, but the tempo swing it gives you when you -2 and then Dawn -3 is very strong. So that's the last of the reducers. Now on to the Dawn Efficient Rampers. So Sachi and Penguin, this card didn't need to be a 2K. I don't know why they made it a 2K, but they did. I play this, I think I used this as a 2K counter once today, and I played it at least 5 or 6 times. Being able to combo it with another one of your rampers, a solo ramper such as Ein or Bonclay, means that you get, on your 4 Dawn turn, you can delete something, you can play one of these, get rid of your opponent's first play, and play one of these cards, and instantly ramp back up to 4 or 5 Dawn. And so when you untap, you have 5 or 6 Dawn, which is just absolutely incredible. Allows you to push for game a lot earlier in the early game, like push life extremely aggressively by going 5s, and then you untap and you have 5Ks. Bonclay, this is the bane of Katakuri's existence.
Yep.
I faced one Katakuri today. I got really lucky in the semifinals. Honestly, it was not looking good. They just needed 1K counter, but Bonclay managed to copy a Big Mom after they played it. You think that's your 8K? No, that's our 8K. So our 8K managed to swing and eat a lot of cards and eat a lot of life. The card is incredible.
Yeah.
I really like Bonclay. And then the reason why you want to play all these Dawn efficient cards is because you're, of course, trying to use your leader ability every turn to remove your opponent's board so you could be more aggressive than them, especially blockers such as Sabo and Borsalino. Mm-hmm. More so Sabo these days. I'm not seeing too many Borsalinos. You eat Rebecca for free, which is pretty sweet.
Yeah.
And then probably the best card in the deck, Vinsmoke Reiju. Reiju died for the sins of Law, and in return, we got Reiju. I don't know why we kept getting pluses, but if the number of Dawn on your field is less than or equal to your opponent's, which it always is, and you have 5 cards in hand, which you often do, draw two cards.
Yeah.
I've drawn 4 cards in one turn with this.
Wow.
Raw Dog 1, -3
Raw
Dog, play the other one, draw 2 more cards. Crazy.
Yeah.
Card's absolutely insane. Because a lot of times, so you play one, Raw, draw your two cards,
yeah.
And then you play a Gordon or something on top of it.
Yeah.
And then now you suddenly only have six cards in hand. Dawn minus three, play this one. You have five in hand. You have less Dawn because you just Dawn minus three, draw two more cards.
Got it.
Absolutely bananas. Raiju, if they want to hit the deck, you hit Raiju. This card's absolutely absurd. Yeah. Drawing cards is so strong. From every other card game, putting draw two cards on a card and giving it very no drawbacks in this case.
Yeah.
Insane. Also, it has 1k counter. So, by the way, it's got 1k counter if you ever need it. Next card I'm going to talk about are the blockers. The rest of the deck is actually pretty much all blockers until we get to the rush. Shiraiya, this card's crazy. Very good against the taxi Luffy deck, as people are calling it, Bumblebee Luffy. If you see the one ace deck that somebody's playing in your locals that tends to cook, this is the card you want to see. It copies until the start of your next turn. So if you swing on a leader that's a 9k or swing on a leader that's a 6 or 7k, it stays that power until the beginning of your next turn.
Yeah,
same with blocking. So when you block with this card, you always only need a 1k to counter out with. So this card is just insane. The power of this card is off the charts. I think any deck that plays less than 4 should really reconsider trying to find a cut for it, because it also makes going first extremely efficient, because then you get a 5 lead and then play something. And then the turn after, you can start double playing everything and removing your hand and then feed into Raiju. So that card's incredible. Trafalgar Law, I only play 2. God, I wish I could play more. 2 seems to be the sweet spot for this card. When your opponent is not law-proof, such as Whitebeard or Sakazuki, ripping 2 counters from your opponent's hand, absolutely bananas. Best law I had was earlier this week on a different top 8 with this deck. I got a rip 12,000 power out of a Whitebeard's hand with double law. They had 9 in hand and
poor Mauricio.
Poor Mauricio. I don't want to say it because they'll know. But poor out, that felt good, and it also felt bad. He was my friend, bro.
Yeah. A fallen comrade.
Yeah, fallen comrade. Right? He wasn't after for a solid half an hour. Ripping counter is what you always want to do with law.
Yeah.
This card is just incredible. You want to play it late. You do not want to play this card early, because your opponent's going to get cards no matter what in the early game. You're drawing cards every turn. You want to play this when your opponent's probably only going to draw 1 or 2 cards for the rest of the game. This card's incredible. When your opponent's at 1 life, that's when it really shines. Rip their cards, then they have 5 in hand, and then you can start going for game. Captain Kidd, self-explanatory. You want your Dawn back, and he's a big blocker. He protects all your guys being a 6k, so he makes your 1ks into 2ks to protect your 5ks. It also forces your opponent to Dawn up inefficiently and swing, and 90% of the time, you just let the 5k die, and then your opponent's wasted Dawn. Same reason why you have Queen. Only one time today did I get a Queen with a Kid out. God, it felt good. Free 5 mana, draw 2, discard 1. Oh man, that card is bananas. And you get the Dawn back, so it's actually a 4 cost. Yeah, that feels good. And then the cards you're looting away are often the no counters, which are the extra raise maxes and such, if you don't need them. And you're trying to never discard 2Ks and never discard Raiju.
Yeah.
Those kind cards you need very badly in basically every matchup. It's pretty much the engine. So Kid, I like to call the engine. If you have a single Kid out, you're Dawn minus 2-ing, and you're getting rid of your opponent's 5 and 10 drop, 5 and 6 drops. Seems pretty good. If you have 2 of them out, the game's pretty much over. If you have 3, let's not get into Magical Christmas Land. That's never gonna happen.
Yeah, it looks like he traded sides from Purple Luffy to this deck.
Yeah, I did have Purple Luffy, which is why I have most of this deck.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Zoro, you're only playing 2 Zoro.
Okay, that's surprising.
Deck used to play 4, but you want to play cards like Queen and stuff, because a lot of the times, Zoro, if you play Zoro on, if you go turn 1 or turn 2, play swing 5k, play Zoro swing 5k, you're doing it wrong. Because your opponent gets to swing into Zoro for free, and then they get to starve your life. You need your life in this game. You're going to end the game before your opponent can hit you 4 times. And if you can't, you're losing anyways. So you need your life in every game. So sometimes I do raw Zoro. I just play him for 3 and I pass, which feels bad. But that's why you have Shiraiya in the deck. But then Zoro's cool. But yeah, of course, Zoro does push for game. That's usually what you want to use him for. Dawn minus 3, play a free 5k, get a Dawn back with Kid, swing 6 or 7. Card's incredible. Has been since OPO1. But he's outshined by this guy.
Oh
man, this card is bananas. I've drawn 4 of a kind one time, and my opponent just couldn't counter out. It didn't matter. He had 6 in hand,
yeah.
And I'm like, yeah, like play Kid and Killer. because I had one on board, and I'm like, all right, play Kid and Killer. It's like, okay, cool, cool, cool. So seven, eat two cards, cool. Seven, eat two cards, sweet, sweet, sweet. Play a third. He's no, like, oh, all right, he has three. Seven, eat two cards. He's like, sweet, okay. Like, he's got, you know, he's got one hand. He's like, oh, you got two Dawn left there. I'm like, okay, you know, 5K lead. Let's see what he does. Discard one card. Minus three Dawn. Get back a Dawn with Blocker Kid.
Yeah.
10K Kid and Killer. Yeah, that, this card is bananas.
He's
Dawn efficient by one, and just being Dawn efficient by, and in that manner of speaking, being Zoro's a 3-mana 5K, so being a 4-mana 7K is means that one, you get one extra Dawn value for playing him, and when you're playing a deck that's all about Dawn value, that one Dawn value is enough to steal games.
Yeah.
It eats an extra card, it lets you go 9 with 2 Dawn, it lets you go 8, which is honestly sometimes as good as going 9 against the decks with very minimal 2Ks. This card's just bananas. I don't know why they printed this card. They were like, let's just make the best rusher in the game.
Yep.
How about we do it? This card's so good. Don't touch this card. Please, please, Bandai, don't touch this card. This card is so needed. You can hit any of the other one. Like, I just love this card because if they hit this deck, I'll play another rush deck and I'll play this card. I love him so much. It's the only alt I got for the deck because he's so cool. I think he looks so nasty. He's like, look what we did.
Yeah.
We swung 7K for 4 Dawn. It always, also, the card makes your opponent scared to counter out early. And if they counter out early and try to keep themselves at 3 lives, you're just going to starve them. And starving somebody with this deck is absolutely incredible. It means they can't get value out of their life. It means they can't get value out of cards they draw from life, like triggers. And it also means that often your guys get to stay on board because your opponent's going to have to play their cards from their hand to catch up instead of dawning up and swinging in. Being a 5K swing on your opponent's turn that they get to swing into is the only downside. But man, your opponent's trying, you're trying not to give your opponent a turn when you're playing King Killer. And you might notice that's 49 cards. There's only one card left. What could it be? It's Sanji. The reason you play Sanji is because of the NL matchup. A lot of people choose to play Sanji over another one of the 2Ks. I just couldn't bring myself to cut another card. As explained earlier, I'm greedy on the fact. But you play Sanji over Kamazo, Kamazo is his name. The Kamazo is the 4-mana 2K, 4-mana 2K, 5K that you can, when you sack a Dawn, you get to kill something that costs one or less, two or less.
Yeah.
Only good against people who are playing Rosinante decks, so Perona. Sometimes blocker, if they're playing Castle Kid or Castle Yamato, very good in those matchups. Most of the time, though, it's for the mirror, and it makes the mirror a little better. I hate the mirror. Actually, it was the only loss I had today. It was round one to the mirror. My opponent I played was just honestly straight up better at the deck. Josh is just, he's the king when it comes to red purple law. He's been playing this deck way longer than I have. He had everything on lockdown. I got really lucky that I actually played him round one and lost rather than later in the game day and lost to him. But Sanji, you play for the NL matchup. NL doesn't swing at your life, so you play a Sanji and you activate him as soon as possible to get yourself to 3 life to protect all of your 4 drops, which is 90% of the deck from Godatsu and Yamato. Otherwise, this deck's extremely aggressive. I would recommend going first if you feel like you need to play Kid on curve, because Kid is your engine, as mentioned. That card's incredible. I would recommend not dying Dawn minusing until you have at least 5 Dawn or you have a Sachi and Penguin in hand.
Okay.
Even if it leaves your opponent with a threat, that's 5k, because it'll be 5k or less, honestly, on the first few turns, unless they do something really nasty. And you can just clear that with swings. You're going to have more swings than your opponent. What this deck loses to is it loses to Anel's good triggers. It loses to
every deck.
It loses to Starvation against cards, decks like Anel.
Yeah.
It loses to other red-purple laws that are more aggressive than you.
Yeah.
The more aggressive red-purple law is going to win. And it loses to big, wide blockers. So if Gecko goes wide with blockers such as Rebecca, Borsellino, Sabo, if they have got any combination of those on the field, you're probably going down. And Purple Luffy, I think, is a pretty mid matchup. But I haven't seen many Purple Luffy's recently, unfortunately. But
real quick, what were your matchups throughout the whole day?
Round one, Red Purple Lamir. I lost to my good friend Josh. By losing to him, I learned how to play the deck better, and that helped me in my later rounds. He's like, right, that's why I
learned. Learn as you go.
And then I beat. Oh man, God, what a round two. I'm already.
You want to group them up? Like how many of the games you played?
I could see the stats on the Bandai app. This will help me. So round one absolutely was a banger of a round. Red Purple Lawmere, crazy. Never want to see it. Still insane. And then I played against Anel. I got really lucky. He didn't get any triggers out of life except for one Kiki Nojo, which I bottom decked because I had a Gordon on board. So I was like, okay, sweet, adios. Like, I needed to use this anyways. And then I faced my good friend Ben. He was playing Gecko Moira. That was a crazy, crazy matchup. And then I faced Edward Newgate, which he could have won if he swung 9 instead of 8. He swung 8. I had 9. I got really lucky in that matchup. I got a law him one time. I kept my opener because it had law.
Yeah.
Against Newgate, yeah, you just want laws. Law's so strong. And then I faced in my last round of Swiss, I faced another Anel who got really good triggers out of life, but their hand was Katakuri, Big Mom, Katakuri,
yeah, no play.
Yamato. He just had all bricks in hand. He had like 4 hand. I'm like, 5k yeah. lead. He's like, take it. I'm like, you're dead, man. I'm like, I got 2 Kidding Killers in my hand. I'm about to blow you out of the water. And then I guess Kid Killers helped, honestly. That was pretty good. And then in top 8, round 1, I faced another Gecko Moira who did. They played their Victoria Sindris to try to get stuff in their trash.
Yeah.
And they did hit 2 Absalom out of that, but I was able to bottom deck both the Absaloms. So later in the game, when he went, there was a big, big swing where he went Dawn under Gecko, had 2 Dawn left. Or 3 Dawn left, Great Eruption, target Shiraiya, draw card, activate Gecko skill, try to mill the 4th Absalom, and he missed. If he had hit that Absalom, I would have lost.
Yeah.
I would have had 1 less swing on his life, and I would have lost. And then, by having that 1 less swing, that was gas. So I was screwed if he didn't have that. And then I faced Katakuri. People meme, people say Katakuri is Law's easiest matchup. I'm terrified every time I play that deck.
Yeah.
That deck's scary. I don't know what you guys are talking about. You get 7 bomb, 10 bomb. You got 2 triggers out of life. At any point, if you had a Maru trigger or any good, or a, I mean, obviously, they build their deck around the triggers from life. So it's not even like, oh, they got lucky. It's like, that's the deck. Like, you have to play into that. You triggered 1 Onami to kill my kid, and that was my only kid. So I lost my engine mid-game without even swinging with the kid. I swung 5, and he killed the kid. So I guess I didn't neg it because he would have killed it anyways, but looking back on it, I probably should have swung with the kid first because I was at 2 life and I couldn't die. So kid, getting aggro with kid is very good. 1 Dawn under kid, swing, activate leader effect, get the Dawn back, huge. I got really lucky in that matchup. And then after Katakuri in the finals, I played Sakazuki, which I won 2-0 against.
Wow. It was a best of 3?
It was best of 3
okay.
against the Sakazuki. Game 1, I won the die roll. I went 2nd, and I was able to play 2 Bonclays and Sachi and Penguin to ramp myself to victory. So Bonclay's sweet because after I played the Bonclay, I got a Gordon because you get to play the Gordon for free since you get the Dawn back active. Yeah. I don't know why they give you the Dawn active. That makes no sense. They're just like, here you go. We'll make this 4 drop even better. I guess it is a 4 mana 1k, but it also prevented him from playing any Gecko Moiras against me, since Gecko Moira makes my Bonclay a 9k, and they're at 2 life most of the game, so he couldn't risk it. And then game 2, he made me go first, which ended up being a godsend, because my opener was 2 queens and a kid and a Shiraiya, and a Vinsmoke Reiju, so I just blew my hand, ended up drawing an Sachi Penguin, blew my hand. Bottom deck to Kuzan. Bottom deck to seven drop Borsellino. Bottom deck to Sabo, and that was it. He couldn't come back from that. I didn't get Law that game, unfortunately. I got Law the previous game. It didn't matter. But I did end up going with 4 Dawn on my last turn because I was playing aggressive. Swing 5K lead, swing 5K, swing 7K with a kid. 3 Dawn, play Zoro, swing 6k Zoro, takes his last life. I'm like, all right, 7k with another kid because I had kid and queen on field. And then I was like, all right, Dawn minus 3, kid and killer. You got 3 cards in hand. I got 2 life. You got it? No, you didn't have it. And that was it. So
and that's that.
Victory.
That's all she wrote.
Just play super aggressive against Sakazuki. Bottom deck all their stuff.
You have to.
Don't swing into their stuff.
Yeah.
That's what they want you to do. They want you to swing into their stuff, install the game so they can play Gecko Moira. But that's all she wrote.
You were able to go, you want to go second against Sakazuki?
Oh yeah, you want to steal their second every time.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, that's the only matchup I know whether to go first or second against. Second against Sakazuki. They don't deserve it.
All right, well, you won you won your first time here at Top Choice Gaming and the last tournament, unfortunately. But it's still, bittersweet. And then, hopefully you'll get to home. And are you going to keep this card?
This is getting graded, 100%. This is getting framed next to the mat that I won the first time.
Yeah,
last
and this
year.
Mat as well. So he won this
mat. Oh, yeah, I got this mat too.
So this mat was also a gift or a prize as well. So.
Yeah, a gift from Pete, head judge here, who also does judging at Core and Core TCG and events and stuff. He's super cool.
Yeah, I hope to see you more in the future, Jack Fest, from different locals. Hopefully there's another big case tournament somewhere, and I'll catch you on that.
Fingers crossed. I hope so, too.
Yeah,
thank you.
Yeah, yep.
Thank you, sir.
Peace out.
All right. Have a good one, guys.